Good evening all. I'm Pratik and welcome to the one-on-one webinar. It's a very important topic that we have today, and that is enhancing employee performance. And of course, we'll discuss on the strategies for successful reviews in that particular context. So in today's evolving workplace, performance reviews have become more than just a formality. And they are a crucial tool for employee development, engagement, and organizational success. However, inconsistencies in reviews, outdated practices, and challenges from remote and hybrid work environments can diminish their effectiveness. Organizations must focus on fairness, consistency, and modern approaches to drive actual value from performance evaluations. Now, today we'll be exploring more on that. And with that, you know, we have a very esteemed guest with us, Mr. Shiv Khandelwal. Welcome, Mr. Shiv, to this one-on-one dialogue, industry dialogue. So before we proceed, Mr. Shiv, so just a little bit of an introduction for Mr. Shiv. While it's a huge introduction, it would take lots of time, but then I will try to keep it concise. So Mr. Shiv is currently the senior manager HR for IFFCO. It's basically Indian Farmers Fertilizer Corporation. And he also is double-hatting as head HR for IFFCO Ibasar. So he's basically double-hatting for both the organizations. Apart from what he does professionally, then he also is into many other stuff. Just to mention a few more, like, you know, he was elected as the youngest secretary of NIPM for the UP chapter. That was in 2014. He was also nominated for the board member of NHRD, again in the Lucknow chapter. And a very prestigious, you know, prestigious award that he got in the year 2024. He was selected as a top 100 young HR by People Business and Tapai Awards. So indeed a huge recognition. Apart from that, he also is into, you know, organizing various meetings, lectures, quizzes, seminars, predominantly under the banner of NIPM. And he has also delivered various talks on All India Radio at Akashvani Bhavan, Lucknow. So these are just a few, you know, pointers that, you know, I thought I would just, you know, tell for the viewers. Apart from that, there's a plethora of other, you know, achievement that he has, which we can probably at a later point of time, you know, discuss. So welcome, Shiv, once again for this one-on-one industry dialogue.
Thank you, Pratik.
Yeah. So Shiv, as you know, the topic for today's discussion is enhancing employee performance. Okay, what is happening, Shiv, is inconsistency in performance reviews, you know, across teams and departments can lead to perceptions of bias and unfair treatment. Now it happens that way. While we don't want it to happen, but then inconsistencies do come in, okay, in performance reviews across teams and departments. And it can also have a, you know, potentially affect the morale of the employee, and as well as the engagement levels of the employees. So my question to you, Shiv, is what strategies and practices can an organization use to maintain fairness and consistency in performance evaluations now in order to ensure that employees are judged by the same standards, so employees don't feel biased that way? So your take on that, Shiv.
Before taking this particular question on the performance evaluation, I would just give a brief about my organization where I belong. I mean, both the organizations, IFFCO and as well as IFFCO Ibasar Limited.
Yeah.
Well, IFFCO is one of the agriculture company, which is basically into the trading of chemical fertilizers. And recently it has, made a very remarkable, movement in the era of agriculture scenario, not only in India, but across the world.
Yes.
We have converted a 50 kg bag into a 500 ml bottle. Nano fertilizers has been launched by our organizations, and you'll be glad to know that one of the meals that you are taking, Mr. Pratik, or your viewers are taking, it's all because of IFFCO. And this is a very small introduction about my organization, IFFCO. And IFFCO e-bazaar is basically just like the modern e-bazaars, modern bazaars that we are having, the grocery shops in the urban part of the country, like the big bazaar or something like that, where you get under one roof, you get all the grocery products. In the same way, in the rural part of the country, in the hardcore rural part, you name it, like the block level or the village level, we are opening agriculture outlets wherein a farmer can get anything regarding the farming inputs, like wheat, seed, fertilizer, pesticides, insecticides, agriculture machineries or maybe seaweed extracts, promoters. So this is a brief of my organization. And now coming to the question that you raised about the strategies and the practices an organization can use for the fairness and consistency yes. in the performance evaluation. Well, to be very frank, Pratik, and I'll be very honest with you and your viewers, that it is a dream for any HR professional and business manager that indeed the fairness and consistency should be in the evaluation process. Mm-hmm. And at max, what an HR professional can do is to, you know, minimize the biasness in the evaluation process. And how he can do it is by involving herself or himself in every step. You know, he should raise questions about each ratings and evaluating the, you know, whatever the whosoever he's been evaluating the individual on the same parameters. But he should at least, you know, make some strategies that the parameters should be more or less same for all the employees across the yes. sector. So it can be one of the good strategies which one can follow. And in a way, one of the strategies that we followed at IFCO Bazaar, you know, we evaluate our employees both on the sales perspective, since it's a trading organization, and behavioral aspects also. So what we do is we give more weightage to the sales aspects, but in a way we give equally weightage to the, you know, behavioral aspect also. So in case, say, suppose an employee is getting a very good sales, but his behavioral aspect is not good, then he'll be evaluated on a very, you know, wrong path.
Right.
That we
right.
need to do something. And now the point comes about the, you know, biasness. So what we have done is we have made a calibration committee over here, which meets before ratings are disseminated to examine assessment scores. And then they can make, you know, revisions as they need it to ensure that the standardized scores are across the organization. So even when the sales targets are being set, it is based on the, you know, this is one of the behavioral aspect. Even if the sales targets are being set, it is not set just by having a discussion with the employee or his seniors. It is being set based on the potential of the area, you know, the agricultural area. So that a logical formula can be framed and logical targets could be done and biasness could be decreased.
Right.
So this is what we are doing at IFCO Bazaar.
Right. I think good here. I think a very good perspective on this. So basically what I understand, Shiv, is, you know, quantitative and qualitative aspects are both, you know, given good weightage. Also the logic of target setting, etc., so that the biasness can be eliminated, you know, to extent that, you know, while you know, people can still feel that, you know, that biasness will still exist. But then I think whatever you said as an organization that you follow is, I think, great for the, because that will, of course, help us to remove some of the biasness. I think a lot needs to be done. So on that bit, you know, I hear you saying that, you know, also, you know, data analytics also helps, like you mentioned briefly about, you know, the, you know, the area that that potential of the area probably will be utilized to set targets, etc. Okay. So then obviously the data and analytics do play a bit of a role in that. So apart from that, do you use data and analytics in any other form in order to, you know, remove this inconsistencies, if any?
Yeah, sure. I mean, data is, yes, indeed. In today's arena, data is the most important part and it can play a pivotal role in the organization. This will be, you know, answering your earlier question also.
Yes.
You know, that means how you can decrease the biasness, and it's all because of the data that you have. And data help is, you know, helps in getting the fairness and, you know, removing the inconsistency in the performance appraisal evaluations also. I'll give you one example where we are using this data, you know, a lot, apart from what I've stated earlier. It's being where we are doing the annual appraisals and, you know, increments.
Right.
So we get a lot of data, you know,
right.
In terms of sales, right. In terms of profitability, in terms of losses that the stores have incurred, in terms of the, you know, monthly subsidy that we are getting, the impress that we are paying to the employees, you know, the kind of data that we get, a lot of data. Now you need to analyze those data into meaningful results.
Yes.
Now,
yes.
That meaningful results will give you the increment level that you need to set. Now, if I'm giving an increment to 1 or 2 person and there is not set formula, then every day I'll be getting a lot of grievances from the employees. ki I have got this much of an increment and my colleague has got this much of increment. And ours is a very fair organization wherein everyone can calculate his own increment and, you know, what will be his increment. So he knows where he is standing.
Okay. So okay,
we,
okay.
We do a set of formula and they will be knowing how much increment they deserve based on the formula that has been derived based on the data available to us. So in a way, they'll know how they have to proceed further. And in this will in turn, you know, in, helpful be in the growth of the organization.
No, I think that's a very transparent way of, you know, evaluating and also give the candidate or employee a guideline what he or she should do in order to get a particular rating or increment, right? So that I think that is one of the things that many of the organizations are struggling to do. So I think kudos to your organization for having, you know, figured out this way. And obviously you also play a very significant role in that particular thing. Okay, so just moving on to the next one. So say, I mean, do you as an organization have a remote as well as a hybrid work culture in organization currently?
No, we don't have.
You don't have that, right?
We have a remote in the sense, in the remote part of the company, our employees are working, but in a way, hybrid sort of a thing. It's not feasible also.
Right, absolutely. For your case, it's not feasible. So there are organizations, you know, I mean, just to understand, I mean, while your organization will not have, okay, but then just for my just the consumption, now supposing for those organizations where you have this remote and hybrid work settings, okay. Now, would you be able to, you know, probably throw some light on what challenges your organizations face in such environments where you have this hybrid work, whereas, you know, you mentioned something about the behavioral aspect as well. So when people don't come in into the office, you don't even get to know the behavioral aspect of probably an employee who has joined recently. So how do you think that you can tackle those complexities? I'm not talking about IFCO, but I'm talking the general.
In general, you're talking about. See, this will be something based on my experience and the knowledge that I have. Whatever I've gathered through maybe some newspaper or readings. I think the main challenges that the hybrid model will be having can be classified into five C's. The five C's challenges, which is the communication, coordination, connection, creativity, and culture. So these are the challenges the organization which are, you know, going for the hybrid model may be facing. I mean, in terms of communication, will be having problem in terms of the culture imparting, because the cultural, you know, the kind of culture that the organization has in the hybrid model is very difficult to impart that kind of a culture amongst the employees. Then there is a connectivity issue. Then there is a creativity and coordination issues that may be for organization facing. I think, this is something which is being, a lot of organizations are facing also in today's arena. And that's the reason the organizations are calling all their employees back to the offices. And it's been started. And I think the leader has a very important role to play among this. The leader has to play a very important role. So have a better communication, coordination, and, you know, culture setting. So this is something I think the problems that the hybrid model will be, I mean, have in.
I understand. I go that as well, Shiv. Yes. Five C's very effectively said. I think those are very important aspects. But then I think, it's easier said than done. Because, you know, hybrid environment, you know, I have been also privy to some of my previous organizations where this hybrid environment was there. And of course, people do face challenges in addressing this. Thanks for that, Shiv. Now, another point, another very important aspect, Shiv, is, you know, now there are performance issues, that do crop up from time to time and which also, you know, and also affects your team productivity as well of a particular individual. If he's not performing or if he is not performing to the optimal. Now, it is essential that we communicate it in such a way that, you know, it does not discourage the employee, but instead we also put our point through, right? So what approaches and techniques can you feel as a manager use to provide constructive feedback and address performance concerns without maintaining the employee while maintaining the employee motivation. So employee should not feel demotivated saying that you are giving a straight feedback, for example. Okay.
Exactly.
But how do you do that?
In a very subtle way, we can give you a feedback also. So regular, no doubt, regular feedback is one of the aspects which an organization must follow. because it's very important. The competition is something gone are the days when you have a, you know, annual feedback. You know, annually you had a feedback and then you come to know about your, you know, where you stand after the year. And today's, you know, days when the competition is a cutthroat competition, wherein every single second the technology is changing, every single second your organization might be facing a lot of problems. Yes. So regular feedback is something which I personally, you know, as an HR person, feel that should be incorporated into any, every organization in today's arena. And I can give you one of the very innovative approach that we at IFFCO Bazaar has followed. It's a very unique and, you know, recently we have got an award for this also, that every Sunday, you know, we are organizing a Paathshala, which is on an online platform, wherein right from our managing director, chief executive officer is, and every single employee of the organization is joining. And wherein we discuss our, you know, the products, the feedback, even on the feedback on the product is also important. That is also an appraisal part of the thing. You know, until unless you're not getting the feedback about your product and you're only, you know, every day you are doing only the appraisal part of your employees and not the appraisal part of your product will also lead, you know, lead your organization in a wrong way. So everyone is joining and, you know, we are giving approximately 10 minutes for the performance appraisal in a sense, like our feedback from the employees. Okay, what are your feedback from the market? What are your feedback? How we can improve your, you know, capabilities? So these are the kind of things that we are doing at IFFCO Bazaar, and wherein, you know, there is no, you know, what do you call it, middleman or middle management, right from the lower management to, you know, upper management. Everyone is on the same stake, and we give our opinions that this is what an organization should do. These are our suggestions. You know, HR can take these suggestions also. Apart from that, the, you know, market suggestions, we can do, you know, what's happening in the market. So we do everything, every sort of suggestions. So the feedback is very important. And, you know, frankly speaking, sometimes what happens in the organization is that the higher management don't get the actual feedback.
Right.
Okay, what is the actual feedback? So these kind of, you know, interventions can help the organization to achieve, you know, to get the actual feedback from the employees. So in case, say, suppose an HR person, me as an HR person, is hiding something from the my higher-ups. So there is a direct linkage.
Yes.
So open door policies is something which should be there. And that's why our organization has grown many folds, which we started in 2016. We started with an idea in 2016, and today it's more than 2,500 crores company, more than 100 crores of profitability. And we are on the, you know, on our toes. Every Sunday, we are on our toes. So we get a lot of ideas. We implement some ideas. Some are been eradicated because of some reasons. But this is the feedback we follow. And then, you know, sometimes you may ask how you evaluate. Say, suppose when we are having some paathshala, or say some like online conversation that we are having, and there are some 10 number of people over there, whether these 10 number of people have got what we have stated during our conversation or not. So we conduct a quiz also in that end of the day. So we get to know how much, you know, how much was the involvement of the employee, what was the, you know, how much they have taken by the, we have that, you know, analytics,
right. It is like, you know, it's not that, you know, you have interacted with them or the top management interacted with them and, you know, whatever would have communicated, you just have a mechanism to figure out whether people have understood that, right?
Exactly.
So through that. And I think one good part, I think for IFFCO, I should compliment IFFCO, you know, very few organizations have that, you know, thing regular, you know, while organizations will have this top management to the lower rung people, connect. Okay, once in a quarter probably, but then the thing that you mentioned every week that you do, right?
Yeah.
Every weekly it happens.
I think it's unique. And we have done more than 95 paathshalas. So every Sunday, 10 to 11, we have to discuss.
And the amazing part
of this is we are not forcing anyone to join.
We are not forcing anyone to join.
That's the best part of it.
So how's the participation? If I'm at, it's a Sunday, it's a holiday for you, right?
It's
a holiday, right? So and
we get 80 to 90% participation.
That's very good.
Our MD is also very happy about it. even the you know, the best part is the what happens when a person is at a store level. Ours is a you know, unique model. When we our employees at the block level or the village level or the you know, district level. So you know, getting interaction with them, the top management, their views. And you know, the nitty-gritty is at the ground.
Yeah.
It's both ways. It's not only for the good for the lower management, good, very good for the top management as well. They're getting insight right since we have launched two products that I talked about, the nano products, nano DAP and nano UPI. So we need the feedback from the employees regularly. And this is something which, as an HR person, we have intervened. You know, there's something when I was studying in my college way back in 2007 and 9, every time we used to hear, you know, you should align with the business strategies, you should align with the business goals. So I was always wondering, how can, as an HR person, I can align? Now, eventually, slowly and gradually, I've understood, see, these are the interventions which HR can do, you know, aligning with the business. Since we have come up with new products, we have to be on our toes. So that's the kind of interactions that needs to be done by the HR also.
No. I think very aptly said, Shiv. I mean, it's a huge thing that I take away from this particular conversation, this management connect, and on Sundays also with 90% participation. That's immensely appreciable. One question, Shiv, is while there has been many. Performance appraisal per se. Now, it's a traditional way that at the end of the year, the performance appraisal gets done and the HR sends out a notice and then people do an appraisal, self-appraisal, and then you do have a manager appraisal and then increment cycle happens. Okay. So that's a normal traditional way of doing things. Now, many organizations are moving away from that. Okay. Now, there is a school of thought in which they say that traditional annual performance reviews may not fully capture an employee's development, okay, and progress throughout the year. Now, some people are suggesting that moving towards a continuous feedback and development model, okay, rather than having a once a performance appraisal at the end of the year. So in your experience, do you think that continuous reviews are better than annual performance reviews? Should we abolish performance reviews by that? I mean, when I say abolish in the sense that, probably we'll do a, entire year. Anyways, we have been doing this reviews for the entire part of the year. So what is that in a performance appraisal bit that we come to know new in such a way that, performance management will retain its relevance?
I think I'll be very honest with this. Since I talked about the feedback session, I personally believe that continuous feedback, continuous appraisals, not appraisals, I mean the performance review should be continuous process. Say suppose yearly targets have been set. So that should be broken into monthly targets and the weekly targets and the daily targets. And if it should be reviewed continuously on a continuous basis, so that one should not wait for the deadwood to sustain the organization for a longer term. If somebody is not working, because it's something where in an area, if you have a deadwood for a longer period of time, it has to be eradicated and it has to be thrown out of the company as early as possible. So if you wait for the annual appraisal performance system, then I think you have to wait for a year and, you'll be losing a lot of money, manpower cost, the training cost, everything. I'm not saying that you should immediately, remove the person from the services. That's not my thought. It's just, my thought is that you should help him in improving himself.
Absolutely.
Suppose I as Shiv Shankar Khandelwal is not performing well as per the mark of Pratik. So what Pratik will guide me every day in, day out, so that my appraisals, which will happen in the yearly, so my yearly should be in a better way. I should get my reviews continuously. Evaluation should be weekly or maybe monthly basis. And wherever I'm lacking, employee is lacking, he should be aware of the facts that, okay, I'm lacking over here. And through these mediums, I can overcome my lackings. So I think this will be a great idea, and whatever the school of thought, this continuous school of thought is, it should be taken in a very positive and very systematic manner. It will be very grateful for the organization to guide the employees also to align with the business goals. Further annual appraisals will be helpful in deciding the annual, increments also, and promotional strategies to be executed in a very effective manner. That's my thought.
I think, Shiv, that is very, practically and very nicely put it across. So what I essentially understand is, while you still think that performance appraisal has to be there in one form, but then it has to be a continuous feedback, like you have been emphasizing that over the webinar that we have been conducting now. Now, see, on this particular aspect, what happens is if you give continuous feedback and document that as well. It's not that giving continuous feedback. So once you document that on a monthly basis or a quarterly basis, whatever it is, I think that essentially will help you to, at the end of the year, when you do the performance appraisal, it will just be, just giving the feedback
hearing from the person and then finally, you know, getting the appraisal done. Those are good points that we discussed. Apart from that, I think we discussed overall on the performance appraisal bit. I'm sure our listeners would have lots of insights from whatever as IFCO as an organization is doing, the good practices that they're doing, as well as, you know, kudos to you as well as your team for bringing across such nice practices. I think I enjoyed a lot in this webinar. Thanks a lot for being here.
Thank you so much, Pratik. I enjoyed a lot during this conversation with you and your team. Thank you so much for calling me.